So overhook, we want to be turning our wrist towards us. That lifts our elbow. Okay? That's what lifts our elbow. We don't want to have our wrist towards us. We want to have the back of our wrist towards us. You can kind of see like looking at our watch. That's what lifts our elbow. That's what when I have here, that's what's capturing his elbow and making sure that elbow can't pull out. It's turning like this. Okay, we want to be weaving from the inside to be pulling back. Okay, if I was to be looking for an underhook, I'd be weaving from the outside. Okay, if I'm looking for an overhook, I'm gonna be weaving from the inside. Okay, now I want control from the other side as well. We're just pulling down. We gotta make sure that we're keeping our elbow inside of him. Okay? He wants to weave his hand in, and I wanna make sure I keep my elbow inside. So a lot of times I'm connecting my elbow to my thigh. I don't have to have my knee through yet, but I'm just connecting my elbow to my thigh. Alright, we're getting our leg out. To get our leg out, we're gonna be pushing our knee down, and it's gonna swivel our leg out the side. Here, if I turn down, swivel my leg out the side. Okay, I don't want to be pulling this straight out. I want to swivel it out the side. Okay, then from here, I'm going to the knee hug. Okay, my knee hug, I'm not grabbing my shin, I'm just stapling like this with my forearm. Okay, the knee hug is the biggest part of your rubber guard, it's the biggest part of your high guard. What contains the shoulder, okay? It's just the knee hook. Because maybe I'm gonna grab rubber guard over here, maybe I'm gonna go to knee hook. Maybe I'm not gonna grab anything there, and we're just gonna clear the head. But all that happens only if I have the shoulder control, okay? So that shoulder pinch right there, the knee hook. But whether I have the arms on me or not, if it's here, and I have his head for a second, I'm gonna push that in, and pinch, and I can still knee hug right here. So it's a knee hug that holds the arm. That's basically what our overhook is. It's now our overhook is the knee hug. Just turn a little bit. Show knee hug. Okay, so the knee hook is going over top of the foot. Turning the back of our wrist, we're going to over top the foot and go push on the shoulder right here. Okay? Now this hand wants to come from having the elbow on the inside. We're trying to find the elbow inside. Now I want to find the web grip on the inside. The web grip can either be thumb on the inside or thumb on the outside. If the thumb's on the inside, I'm going to be pushing him down. If the thumb's on the inside, on the outside, and the fingers are on the inside, I'm going to be pushing him out and up. Okay, because he can always only go against my thumb. He can't ever fight my fingers. Alright. Now, we're trying to use this to get our knee through. We always want to place our knee towards the mat. That way we can force down a little bit more and we want to pull it to our own chest, okay? Now, once we're getting this through, we have to get our foot through their thigh, and at first, they're going to be like driving into us, and their thighs are going to be going through the thigh. The thighs are going to be blocking, but we're going to be able to use his driving to be able to also make space, be able to also kind of push against him as well. When he pushes against us, he gives us his weight. And then we have these tools here, this knee hook, we're going to push back, make a little space, and get our foot through. Now once we get our foot through, we need to first extend against this arm before we kick down and come through. Okay? So we can't just pull our foot straight through. We have to extend against the arm, then drop and come through. Now you want to go to a reverse triangle right here. You don't want to just switch right away to the regular triangle. So once we're here, we're going to come on top, grab around your foot, right here. The reason we want to do that reverse triangle first is because because the lock is located right above the head, how it's hard from the posture. Okay, and I also like to go to this reverse first because then I, because he can't posture, it's really hard for him to get out, I get to set up how I like to go to the regular triangle first before I switch. The way I like to go to regular triangle is I like to underhook on this arm. And once I find the underhook on this arm, then I go ahead and grab my shin. I'm kind of waiting, feeling like when it's a good time, that feels like I can switch, okay? So if his hands were, let's say they were locked or something, or they weren't in the right position, I want to manipulate his hands so they're in the right position first. Then I feel like I'm good, I have a nice underhook in the right position. And I go ahead and grab my shin and I start to switch. I use this underhook, really grabbing this underhook to make, force this angle right here. Then I switch into my triangle. We want this to be a scissor style choke where we're scissoring our legs like this. Now this triangle in, but our legs are scissoring like this. We'll grab the angle here, but for the most part I'm just using this underhook for an angle, and I grab the head right here. Also on the meat hook, we had another option where if they're really grabbing our thigh. One option is, let's say this grab is a little bit high, then I can easily weave under here, push out, and then recontrol. Okay? But now if this hold is really deep on my thigh, really low, then I might not be able to weave under like that. So we're gonna go inside the thigh right here, we're gonna grab on top of the shoulder, and this hand right here is gonna funnel along the arm until we get down here. It's just going to keep on going, so keep being a battle until we get here. We're going to pull down. That's going to take us right to the trunk. Okay, now the last option with the meat hook is clearing the head to the go-go clinch. Okay, so we're here. We're fighting, battling. I don't want to go for this when he's really kind of squared me up and I'm like flatting my back. I want to go for this when we're on our side, because if I'm flat on my back, I'm going to be able to find the triangle because my legs will be able to get through. You know? But if I'm on my side, you might be able to trap this your leg in and you're just not finding a way to get out. But look how much room we have here. So we're going to clear the head with that. So I'm going to switch hands. This meat hook hand is going to switch with the other hand. This hand's going to be pushing on the shoulder and we're going to pull back with this one, right here. It's gonna pull it over. This hand's gonna stay right where it was. And then this hand's gonna grab around your knee. We're grabbing a gable grip. And then now, I just wanna find my heel to my knee, and then extend with that and pull with my gable grip. You want this to, you wanna just like go fast. You want this to be something that you can pull and hold for 10 seconds or more. It should be a slower blood choke. So try and pull to a point where you feel like you can hold it for 10 seconds and make it a slower blood choke. Okay? Yeah, it should be something that's like putting them to sleep.
Yeah.
Now we had some entries. One entry was an over-under S-grip. Over-under S-grip is just going to be anytime you can find an underhook, then just throw over with the other arm, grab an S-grip, and now you can use that to pull them back and have your knee kind of come through that spot. Find that over under S grip from standing. As long as I can find an underhook, then I can just go over with this one. I have that over under S grip. Now I want to put my butterfly in on the side that my rubber guard is. Sit back. Double unders S grip. grip. I'm going to be pulling back, widening my elbows, pushing against them. I can flip these feet out at the same time, or I can try to pull them a little bit lower. And now from here, I want to take this grip and bring it over one shoulder while still keeping the other shoulder intact. That's what's going to start making one of these elbows fold in. And then typically he's going to start like kind of pulling back as well himself. So I start on my knee, I grab my shin, get his rubber guard. This arm's already folding in. I'm just going to pump it a couple times. And we're going to go to our dead orchard. When we go to our dead orchard, tighten up like this. We're hugging the knee, grabbing our wrist, and we're waiting for this guy to kind of push into us and stack us himself. So that brings our hips up, and then we're ready to go right here. We let go of the knee, we go two on one. We really have to make our hips, our hip as straight up as we can, because the more straight up I make it, the more room I have here for the arm break. The more it's here, the more it's going to hit my own chest. And also too, if I just pull straight, as long as it's good, I want to turn it like this. It's my hip. Same as any arm bar, be turning the thumb and pulling against the hip. In general, when you're entering rubber guard, off the overhook, try and keep in mind, like, this knee hug and being a little loose right here and thinking about if this guy pulls away or if he looks away or anything, that he's giving you the ability to throw over for that go-go clinch. Okay, so you don't have to right away. If you're trying to be pulling tight into a rubber guard, we can be just hugging our knee and maintaining a hold over here while we see if this guy's gonna give us any room or we kind of force room to be able to clear the head. This go-go clinch is a nice quick attack. I have to be able to grab his head on this side though. And I just throw over, ready for that go-go clinch. I think that was nice. That was all the stuff. Good. Thank you. We'll check the time. Cool.
Yeah, you're right. Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Alright,
sorry about that.